SMTV Live. SMTV Live. SMTV Live. SMTV Live. We are S, supersonic. We are M, magnificent. We are C, touch the living. We are V, very smashing. We are live. We are M, monkey lovers. We are G, touching really. We are B, right, fantastic. We are live. SMTV Live. SMTV Live. SMTV Live. SMTV Live.
To be on a Saturday morning, baby. And thanks to Ant for writing this week's song. He wrote all the lyrics himself. Well done, Ant. It was virtually incomprehensible.
Thank you. No one's ever said that to me before.
Yeah, well done, mate. Let's find out what else is coming up on today's S-H-O-W.
Five join us live from the studio to play their new single, Keep On Moving, and If You're Getting Down.
Think you can be a Pokemon trainer? You've got to master the game. Find and catch all 150 Pokemon monsters, train them up and thrash your mates. We're going to help you with two episodes of Pokemon the Cartoon.
Michael Owen's here, but can his mental pace run rings around the defensive might of Ant McPartlin? Get the full-time result in Celebrity Challenge Ant.
Splat, splat, win, win. Two visits to Splatoon with five.
Meow, meow, talk, talk. Sabrina and her cat are back in two premiere episodes of Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
Sing, sing, talk, talk. We're joined by Kylie Minogue.
Emma Bunton moves in next door in Chums.
Find out who'll be moving in next door in Chums.
I've just told you, Emma Bunton.
Oh, sorry.
Pay attention.
Right, okay. It's got the rhyme, it's got the rhyme. Don't you understand? It's got a rhyme. It's Wonkey Donkey.
And Bewitched, Westlife and Robbie Williams make CDUK more fun than a greased weasel.
Good morning to our Saturday morning squad, and they are the St Mary's School from Putney. Yeah! Good morning,
top of the morning. We've got our cheerleaders. Nice waistcoat. As ever, we've got our cheerleaders in the studio with us.
We tried to take it off. No, we tried to take it off you, but you wouldn't give it up.
Hey, listen, we've got our cheerleaders with us. They are, this week, they're little foxes, and they're all waiting to be released into the wild. Take it away, girls.
Just because they're in cardboard boxes,
Sorry, it's my Android and I thought it said foxes, but in fact it says they're the Maidstone Majorettes and Cheerleaders. Sorry, my handwriting's terrible.
Wait for it.
Could this carry on?
But I hope not.
It would be good. Now listen, it's a very exciting day here.
It is.
It is indeed.
Because we've got a brand new series starting called Pokemon.
Yes, yeah. Brilliant.
Pokemon. Now it's a craze that's taken over the world. Yeah. It's big in the States and in Japan as well. And you can see it here every Saturday morning here on SMTV.
Yes, indeed. It's really good. Stay tuned for that. Also coming up on the show, Michael Owen will be with us. Celebrity Challenge Ant with Ant a little bit later on. And in honour of that, we've got some fantastic Michael Owen goodies to give away, courtesy of Walker's Crisps. Now, look at these. We've got a football there, we've got a picture, all signed stuff. And probably best of all, though, I think you'll agree, is this Michael Owen signed. Signed Michael Owen English shirt. We're going to be giving that away. If you want it, answer this question. Which football club does Michael Owen play for? It's a tough one. Is it A, Liverpool, B, Partick Thistle, or C, Sparta Girl Guides? If you think you know the answer, give us a call, 09013 81881. Coach, it costs no more than 25 pence, but please get permission from whoever pays the bill. That's Michael Owen coming up, Celebrity Challenge Ant, and a little bit later on. Stay tuned
for that. But now it's time for some top pop, and here with If You're Getting Down, it's Fun!
Thanks, fellas. standing five there if you're getting down. Five will be joining us for a chat a little bit later on. So will Emma Bunton and Kylie Minogue. If you've got any questions for any of them, then get in touch with us. Or you can email us, studio@smtvlive.co.uk, or you can fax us, 0207 737 8393. Get your questions coming along in. But right now, it's time to find out about this morning's round of Splatoon.
Hello. Like I said, hello.
Hello.
Can I rub your bottom?
Excuse me, what? I'm sorry.
I'm Franklin Smint.
Hello.
I do rubbings of famous people's bottoms. Very traditional. Like old brass rubbing at churches.
Well, thanks, but no thanks, Franklin. I'm just trying to do a link here.
Are you sure?
I'm very sure. Thank you. Like I said, later on in the morning, we'll be playing Splatoon. Now, all you have to do is very simple. You've got to phone in. We get a celebrity guest, and you've got to blindfold them.
There's
then
nothing naughty about it.
Listen, I'm trying to do a link here to the nation about Splatoon, and Tasha's coming up and everything. You know?
No, listen. I've rubbed lots of famous people's bottoms. I've rubbed Tom Jones's bottom. It's not unusual. And I've also rubbed Denise Van Houten's bottom.
Well, that's not unusual either, from what I've heard. Now, could you leave me alone, please? I'm trying to do Splatoon.
If you're sure.
I'm very sure. Thank you. Now then, as I said, we'll be playing Splatoon, and our celebrity guest to sit in the chair this week is Five! Yeah! Now, all you have to do is call us up here at the show, tell us which one of Five you want to sit in the chair. They're blindfolded, you get 45 seconds, got to tell them left, right, up, down, whatever, and you got to shoot at our flying sacks of paint. Each one's worth 100 points. Whoever's got the most points at the end of the show wins a fantastic prize. Let me tell you, it's fantastic. It's very good indeed. Let me tell you what you can win this week.
Gonna win.
It's an all-in holiday for two to the Bretton Woods Mountain Resort in New Hampshire in the United States of America, and a family entrance to the ski and snowboard show at Olympia in London from October the 29th to November the 7th. It really is a good prize. Now, boys, you've got to get yourselves on the leaderboard today, okay? Because we've got these are the people who've done it. Jimmy from 911 has got 500 points. That's what you've got. With Kean from Westlife, lovely, got 300. Wayne from Another Level's on about 300. Sol from Holy. Hey! What are you doing?
I got his bum!
Oi, you gonna try and sell that or what?
I hope he's not gonna try and sell it. Do you know why? Because he'd get a bum deal. Anyway, later we'll be playing Splatoon. If you want to play, phone us up with the answer to this question. What's the name of Shania Twain's single? Is it A, Man I Feel Like a Sandwich, B, Man I Feel Like a Woman, or C, Man I Feel Like an Idiot? If you think you know the answer, give us a call, 09013-81-81. Call should cost no more than 25 pence, but please do get permission before you dial. Now, pay very close attention. There's 150 of them. You've got to collect them all. You've got to train them all up if you want to stomp all over your mates with them. It's very good. Here it is. Watch it. It is...
Pokemon!
The end of the show.
As you know, I'm very easily swayed. And after watching Pokemon, I have turned into a mighty Pokemon master trainer.
Ah, so you think so, do you? But do you have the Pokeballs for it?
Wait, think you're hard enough to take on this Pokemaster?
Don't be a fool, Deck. I've been building up my squad and I'm itching for the duel.
Brave words. But stupid ones. Bring on the strongest member from your Pokedex.
Well, remember, I went to the Viridian Forest.
Ah, what, Flippy Floppy? We've all got a Flippy Floppy, Ant.
Speak for yourself, Dick.
No, Flippy Floppy. This Flippy Floppy, is that the best you can do?
Well, you seem to forget that I also went to Celadon City.
Wasting your time. While you were at Celadon City, I went to the SS Arn and clicked all the body slam moves. They're super effective critical hits. Wicked.
So, it is a waste of time getting a elemental stone, is it?
You didn't, did you?
I did.
You didn't evolve Flippy Floppy, did you?
What do you think?
Not into Brown Shoe.
No.
Oh, thank the Lord.
No, into Smelly Welly.
No!
So, pick on your best fighters, Pickle Snacks, and someone else with a ridiculous sounding name.
Ah, you celebrate too soon, Ant, because I choose to defend with Squirts Cream!
The battle commences! I will come forward and use rubbery smell! Smell it! You can't resist it, can you?
I shall defend with Pegmod. That's better.
Ah, right, I see. Ooh, me and Steps have fell out. Right, I will attack with... round your face!
I shall just choose to simply ignore and respond with...
Fill it up!
No! No, how could you? No! No, that welly, smelly welly!
Yeah!
Oh.
Yeah!
Oh.
Yeah!
Oh, look at
yeah.
that! Oh, yeah. It takes so long!
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Oh! 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 Yeah. Oh! 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 Yeah. Oh.
It's super effective! Oh. Critical hit! I am... Wackhead! Okay, Ant, you are defeated! Now, you know what you gotta do.
See you lot after the break.
Do it! Oh. Do it!
Live. Don't forget that we've got part two to Pokemon that's coming
up. It's good.
Up.
It is good.
I'll learn how to say that word really easily.
Pokemon. It's as easy as that. Now, it's time for the SMTV Postbag!
Oh, yes, wait a minute, Mr. Postman. Wait, Mr.
If you could blow it out, make a little wish there.
Shall I make it as dramatic as I possibly
yes,
can?
Yes, please, if you don't mind.
Yay! All these balloons all over the place. Happy birthday. How are
Thanks
you, sir?
Very much.
Not too bad. Kath, I invited you to my party last week and you never came.
It's true.
Should I wouldn't make sure it's for the world.
Well, I don't actually know where I'm going yet. I'm a bit jet-lagged. Today, so I might actually stay in.
Should we keep this for later? We can have this up at the show. This kid?
Why not? Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Happy birthday, Kat.
Into a very special SMTV birthday postbag for Kat. Kat, special family birthday messages from your family to Kat. Happy birthday from Nan and Dad, Granddad Willoughby, from Nan Deeley, from Auntie Hayes, from Lee, Claire, Kay, and Dylan. Oh. Kiss, kiss, kiss. Happy birthday.
Okay. I've got a couple here. It says, special family message birthday for Kat from my family. Happy birthday, Catherine. Love, Jan and Howard. That's your mum and dad,
yes,
isn't it? Happy birthday.
Jan
Thanks for
Howe.
That one. And we've got another one. Happy birthday to my sis. See you tomorrow. Lots of love from your brother, Max.
Oh, he's coming to see me.
Oh, happy birthday. There you are.
Are you having a nice birthday?
I am, yes.
Are you?
Yes.
Is it good to be back on the show?
Yes. I'm taking a holiday, though, again, soon.
Oh, I've already
put in for my next holiday already.
The most wrestling woman in television sitting there right next to us.
I don't want to strain myself. It's working with you two.
Well, did you have a nice holiday, though?
Yes, I had a very nice time. It was actually Amanda's wedding.
Amanda on makeup.
Really?
Amanda on makeup. It was,
was it a nice wedding?
Yes, it was a lovely wedding.
It was lovely
swam
doing the show.
Swam with dolphins and stuff.
Really?
Swam with dolphins, and then this week went to meet Robbie, which is lovely.
That's nice.
Yes.
And, and is it nice to be back, Kat?
Well, I prefer to be shopping with Robbie, really.
Oh, well, I see. Okay. What's all that?
Move swiftly along. We've still got Emma Bunton coming up on the show. We've got Kylie Minogue. Five are here. Get all your emails, please, coming in. 0207-737-8393 is the fax. Studio@smtvlive.co.uk is the email address. Remember, Michael Owen? We've got his England shirt. We're giving that away later on. What's the question for that? The question is, which football club does Michael Owen play for? Is it A, Liverpool, B, Partick Thistle, or C, Sparta Girl Guides? If you think you know, give us a call. 09013 81 81. Course, it costs no more than 25 pence, but please get permission before you dial.
But now it's time for the second part. I'll let Kat introduce us just to see if she gets the name right this time. It's the second part of...
Pokemon.
Pokemon. Yay!
Challenge Ant. Celebrity style.
Welcome to Challenge Ant Celebrity Style. This is the part of the show where Ant tries to prove that he's hip and cool. However, today, once again, we're going to put one of the Jodie Gasbag's more outrageous claims to the test. So let's meet him, bring him on, the king of Challenge Ant, the man with no brain, Mr. Adam McPartland. Hello, Ant.
How are you?
How are you?
Very well, thanks.
Now then, like Ant, the rules for Celebrity Challenge Ant are simple. and picks a specialised subject, makes an outrageous claim about it. Then a celebrity viewer gets to drop 10 secret questions. They then get the opportunity to put those questions to Ant to try and make him look stupid. Ant, what is that claim?
That I know everything there is to know about football. Period.
Why, that is an outrageous claim, Ant.
Isn't it?
And the fact that Alan Shearer rammed those very words down your throat a few weeks ago, that hasn't stopped you, hasn't dented your confidence?
No.
Good. So let's meet the contender for Celebrity Style Challenge Ant. It's a Mr. Michael Owen.
Hello.
How are you, sir?
Well,
sit yourself down. Says here, Michael is 19 years old. His nickname is Midget Gem. And his hobbies include golf, table tennis, snooker, and playing football for Liverpool and England. Is that about right?
It's about right, yeah.
Welcome to the show, Michael. Feeling confident there?
I am, definitely.
Got your questions. Have you had any help with them, or you done them all yourself?
Yeah, my mum's drawn up a few of these. I think she knows a bit more about me
than
myself.
They'll be killers.
Really, so.
They'll be killers.
Right.
Right, today we're playing for Britain's top talented teenagers, according to Total Football magazine. Now then, Michael, at the end of your 10 questions, you can decide whether you want to gamble everything you've won so far on your killer question. And now, if Ant gets that question wrong, then you walk away with all 10 strips. But I have to warn you, if Ant gets that question right, then you lose everything. You go home with absolutely nothing. You prepared for that?
Okay.
I know it's tough, but you're prepared.
I am.
Confident, Ant?
Very much so.
Good luck. Confident, Michael?
Definitely.
Good luck. Let's play Celebrity Challenge, Ant. Okay, then question one is for the 10th most talented teenager, who is Jermaine Pennant of Arsenal. He's 16 years old, and he's currently valued at around £2.5 million. It's a lot of money. Question one, then, Michael, please.
Which football club did I support when I was growing up?
Everton.
Correct.
Yeah.
Straight away. Very confident in there. One little one straight away. So was it strange for you signing for Liverpool then, being an Everton supporter?
Yeah, it was. I went on trial with Everton and went for training for a week or whatever. But I've been at Liverpool since I was about 9 or 10, so I knew all the players, all the staff and whatever, and liked it there more then.
Right, question two then is for the 9th most talented teenager. It's Gareth Barry of Aston Villa, valued at £3 million. Question two, Michael.
Against which club did I score my Liverpool debut as a substitute on 6th of May, 1997?
not a clue.
Not a clue. Do you want to stab in the dark?
Nah. Derby.
No, rubbish. Absolutely rubbish. Wimbledon.
Wimbledon.
Wimbledon. Ones each. Although you lost 2-1, is that right?
We lost 2-1, yeah.
So what are your ultimate football ambitions in the game?
Well, ultimately, to win the World Cup. I mean, we've put in a bid for the 2006 World Cup. So, you know, hopefully if we got that, it'd be in England and to win the World Cup, like so many of the great English players have done at Wembley, would be, unbelievable.
Okay, question three is for the 8th most talented teenager. It's Matthew Etherington of Peterborough. He's valued at £3.5 million. And this is Matthew's very own shirt. There, look at that. It's his own shirt, that, you know. Okay, question three then, Michael.
Against which country did I make my international debut to become the youngest English player this century?
Oh,
now you know this. We watched this.
Chile.
Chile.
Correct.
Yes, get it.
2-1. 2-1 to Ant then. So, you're looking forward to the Euro 2000 playoff between England and Scotland? That's a big game, isn't it?
It's a massive game. I mean, you know, I'm like every other football fan. I can't wait for the game. Excited for the game. You've both got to give 100%. And, you know, I think the first 10 minutes will be frantic in both games. Hopefully, we can compete with them well. And then, hopefully, our skill will prevail at the end of it.
Fingers crossed.
We do hope so.
Okay. Question four, then, is for the 7th. Most talented teenager. It's Steven Gerrard of Liverpool. He's 19 and valued at £4 million. That's a lot of money. Question four, Michael.
My dad, Terry, was a professional footballer. Name one of the many clubs he played for.
Oh. This has got to be another guess. Carlisle?
Nope.
No. Oh. Sorry, rubbish.
Nah.
Twos each. You could have had anyone from Bradford City, Chester City, Cambridge, Rochdale and Portvale. Was it your dad who first got you involved in football?
Yeah, I always liked the game. I mean, I've got two brothers as well that we used to always go down the park and cross balls and score goals and whatever.
Okay, question five for the 6th most talented teenager. It's Leeds United and England's Jonathan Woodgate, aged 19 and already worth £4.5 million. That's a lot of money. Michael.
How many goals did I score in the 1998 World Cup?
Now, I messed up with Shearer last time. Two.
Correct.
Is it?
It is.
Yes. Brilliant.
That's 3-2 there, Uwan. One against Romania and one against Argentina.
Yeah.
That Argentina goal, I have to say, brilliantly taken goal. Goal of the tournament. Do you get a buzz from seeing that back again?
Yeah, obviously. It's, no one can take that goal away from me now. I've done that. And hopefully move on to better things if you can.
And you did so well to score that goal. How did you feel then when David Beckham got sent off towards the end of the game?
Yeah, it was disappointing. I mean, it's hard to play 10 against 11. I thought the lads did really well to hang on. And to be honest, after he got sent off, I think everyone would have settled for penalties because we had a half-decent chance of going through.
He got some stiff treatment, didn't he, when he got back? It was all a bit unfair on him, that.
Yeah, it was a bit unfair because I was getting a lot of... nice words said about me, so it was a bit hard, especially for him.
Righto, question six is for the fifth most talented teenager. It's 19-year-old Robbie Keane, recently transferred to Coventry City for $6 million. Newcastle should have bought him. Michael.
Won't get this one. How many Premiership goals did I score for Liverpool last year?
In the
Premier League.
Oh, seriously. 19.
Oh!
No, nope.
You didn't.
18. Not that good.
18. Oh, 3-0. You were joint top scorer last year, though, weren't you?
Yeah, and the year before.
Right.
I was joint with two other players both times. So.
What happens there then? Do you all get a little bit?
We all get one.
Do
we all get
a
stud each. Yeah. I got a trophy. Unfortunately, I was injured for the last part of the last year, so I was really lucky to hold on to the golden boot, because I thought, you know, I think it was Dwight York needed to score one in his last few games. I thought, you know, playing for Man United, the chances they get, I thought he'd do it. But thankfully, I got it again last year, so I was very pleased.
Well done. Question seven is for the fourth most talented teenager. It's Leeds United's Alan Smith, valued at £8 million. That's a lot of money. Question seven, Michael.
How many times have I been capped for England? No chance.
Oh. No chance. 32 times.
Ooh.
Quite a lot of
absolute time. Rubbish.
Come on.
Half it.
What? 16?
Yeah.
16. Oh, half a shit. Yes.
No, not likely. That's 4-3 now to Michael.
4-3. Yeah.
4-3. Question 8, moving swiftly along. The third most talented teenager is Francis Jeffers, already valued at £9 million. Question 8, Michael.
How many times have Liverpool won the European Cup?
Oh, yeah, I know this one. 4 times.
Correct.
Correct.
Yeah, see?
Correct.
I never knew that.
You
know? 4 each. Question 9 is for the second most talented teenager. It's West Ham United's Joe Cole. He's 17 years old and already valued at £12 million. That's a lot of money. Question 9, Michael.
I'm well known for advertising a particular brand of crisps, but what could you find inside those packets of crisps at the moment?
Oh, the little things. Cubics.
Correct.
Yes, that's correct. Brilliant.
Can you give us a little bit more? Can you describe what they are?
You add them together like a jigsaw type thing. Makes a picture.
Well done.
See?
Well done. There you are. That's score then. That's 5-4 then to one. And edging into the lead there. So, Michael, since everything happened, since the World Cup and all that, how have the people around you dealt with your fame? How have your family taken to it and your friends? Are they all right with it all?
Yeah, no problem at all. I mean, I'd hate to think they'd change their attitude towards me or me towards them. I mean, I'm still a normal person in anyone's eyes.
And what about your girlfriend? How does she deal with you being a heartthrob and having posters up on young ladies' walls all over the nation? Is she all right with that?
Yeah, fine. I mean, she's not got much choice, has she, what other people think. So, what other people think is great. And if I'm if my picture's on some girls' world, whether they like the football side or not, it's nice to be thought of.
Yeah. Righto. Last question then. Michael's last chance to pull it even.
Right.
Final question. For the most talented footballer, teenage footballer in England today, it's Michael Owen of Liverpool, 19 years old, already reckoned to be worth £30 million.
Question 10, Michael. It's your shirt, so obviously you can't play for it. What's going to happen is we're going to have a quick fire round. Ant's going to ask you a series of quick fire questions, and if you pass on any, then Ant gets the shirt. So it's in your best interest to answer all the questions truthfully. You ready?
Okay.
Fire away, Ant.
Right, okay. Simpsons or South Park?
Simpsons.
Steps or S Club 7?
Steps.
Fair Steps or Claire Steps?
Faye.
Why is that then, Michael?
Both. Liverpool to win the championship or England to win the World Cup?
England to win the World Cup.
Right. Coronation Street or EastEnders?
EastEnders.
Christina Aguilera or Britney Spears?
Christina.
I don't even know if that's how you say it. Des Lynam or Gary Lineker?
Des Lineker.
Louise Nerden or Posh Spice? You've got to say Louise.
Louise.
Yeah, you've got to say Louise. Alan Shearer or Robbie Fowler?
Oh, God. Robbie Fowler.
Right. And this is the best one so far to end on. Sabrina's old long hair or a new short hair?
Old long.
Do you think
so? Same here. Old long hair, I agree with you.
Well, I say I'm a big fan of the short hair. Or maybe it's the plunging necklines that I'm a fan of this year, so I don't know.
Well, it didn't pass anyway, so
he didn't pass
shirt.
On any, so he gets the shirt, draws level. There you are. It's 5-5. Well done, Ant.
Thank you, Michael. Thank you.
Well, there you have it then at the end of that. Michael, you've won 5 shirts there, including your own. They're yours to keep. You can take them home or you can gamble them all on your killer question for all 10 shirts.
I'm not a gambling person, but I will gamble.
He's going to go for it. Right. He's going to go for the killer question. Good luck, Ant.
I need to win this one.
You do.
Thank you.
Good luck, Michael. Can we have today's killer question, please?
When did Liverpool last win the championship?
Oh, 1990.
No! It's right!
Come on!
It was 1990. I'm sorry, Michael, I have to take them all away from you. They're all here. Ant wins the crown back once again.
Yes.
The first time Ant's won a celebrity round of challenge, Ant. Well done.
I'll go out now and not be mocked and stoned in the streets.
There we have. And there's the Dunce's cap for you, Michael. You can take that there. There you have. Yeah, well, if you would. The viewers would appreciate it. Oh, look at that.
There you are, see?
Honest to the very end. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. My thanks to Ant McPartland.
Thanks very much.
My thanks to World of Football. And, of course, my thanks to Mr. Michael Owen.
Thank you.
If you're a top celebrity and think you can challenge Ant, then come and have a go if you think you're smart enough. Right to I'm Not Scared of That Geordie Gas Bag, Challenge Ant SMTV Live, PO Box 22122, London SE1 9GL. Come and wipe that smirk off his face.
5 joiners to help shoot down those pesky bags of paint in Splatoon.
Oh, the lovely Sabrina still to come, as well as the latest installment of my novel, Me and Our Lass.
She was the biggest selling female star of the late 1980s, the youngest woman to top the album chart, and even better than that, she's incredibly dinky. It's Kylie Minogue.
She's part of one of the most successful groups of the late 1990s. She's got her own show on VH1, and even better than that, sometimes she wears big white boots. It's Emma Bunton.
It's one of the least successful comedies of the late 1990s. It's silly, really. It's Chums.
He's no Wonkey Donkey, let me tell you. You can win Michael Owen's England shirt.
And there's Bewitched, Westlife and Robbie Williams in CD UK. That's more stars than a truck full of stars with stars nailed to the side.
To SMTV Live, where our radar operator is Cat Deeley. Has some news for us. Cat?
Incoming paint peg, sir.
Thanks. One line, she couldn't even do that.
I'm taking a holiday.
Well, who will be getting a man in the government this morning? Well, it's none other than Rich from Five. Hello, Rich.
How you doing?
Quite comfortable, yes.
Okay,
brilliant stuff. Oh, okay. Chap. Well, we need a caller to direct him on the line. We've got Claire Kidley from Oxford. Good morning, Claire.
Good morning.
Lovely part of the world, Oxford. Very nice town. Okay. Well, how do you play the game, Deck?
I tell you, you've got 45 seconds on the clock. You've got to direct rich left, round, up, down, stop, and splat. Behind me are flying sacks of paint. Each one worth 100 points. Whoever gets the most points by the end of the day wins the prize skiing in the United States of America.
Woo! Great prize. Bet you wouldn't mind winning that, would you, Claire?
No.
Of course not.
Nah.
Okay, good luck to you. Good luck to you, Richie. You can put your goggles on there, please. You've got 45 seconds, as we said, and chucks away.
Rich enters our leaderboard at joint second with Kian from Westlife and Wayne from another level, all on 300 points, and I'm afraid Adam Rickett falls out of the bottom there with no points at all. Adam Rickett falling out of... Oh, never mind. Maybe
good score. Good score. Well done.
You could be in with a chance of winning that skiing holiday to the United States. Stay tuned, another Splatoon later on in the show, but right now let's cross over for this week's visit to that fine young filly, Sabrina.
All this just because I finished my invention for school? You shouldn't have, even though I did spend 3 weeks working on it. Not to mention missing the English patient on HBO 61 times.
Cool your jets, Edison. The horns don't toot for you.
This is for our cousin Larry. What did he invent? Nothing. But cousin Larry has come to expect some fanfare since he became an other realm emperor.
He has his own country. I get dirty looks for taking up too much couch space.
Here he comes.
Zelda, what a delight. This must be Sabrina. Kiss my ring.
But I hardly know it.
I can't wait to talk to you about the family. I have a...
If we're gonna be interrupted, the music might as well be good.
There. I didn't see you there. Welcome back, Sabrina there. More from her a little bit later on in the show. But now it's time for everybody's favourite part of the show. It's the next chapter of my Sabrina novel. Free whoopee cushion for everyone who cheers. There we are. This week it's chapter 6, page 1, Me and Our Lass. Thank you very much indeed. This week, me and the lovely Sabrina have gone back in time to Yulee, England, for reasons that just escape me at the moment, but we do. And it's a time when men were men. Hey! And Ant was dressed like a pansy.
Hey, well, I'm playing you, mate, so who's laughing now?
Not the audience, obviously, yes. And the women had such huge, embarrassing, pointy heads that they had to cover them up with huge, embarrassing, pointy hats. Sabrina entered on a pure white horse named Charger.
Good day to all. Verily and forsooth, I shall be speaking to my agent about this.
Said Sabrina, the year 1299.
You sure? You can get them for $9.99 in Woolies.
All right, $9.99 then. The place, Oldie England. The time, just after lunchtime.
Hail, fair Sabrina.
Are you sure? They said there was going to be sunny intervals.
Sunny intervals, fair Sabrina. Tick, tick. When do I get the kiss of it?
At the end. Just get on with it, will you?
Oh, I can't wait that long. I'm skipping. Light as me. I love thee, Sabrina, truly and verily. And I shall kiss ye on the gob. For about 10 or 15 minutes, I reckon, like.
Hang about us, Dick.
What? What is it, Petal? Divin' ye? Fancies us then? Anything?
Tis not that your Sabrina doth not love thee, but if thou wishest to snoggeth me,
oh, yes,
thou must perform these tasks three, which...
I must thee.
Yeah.
Name it, Sabrina, name it. I'll climb the highest mountain, slay a dragon, walk across a hot, steamy desert. I'm not bothered. Out. Anything.
First, ye must pretend to be a horse, and I shall ride thee to the shops for a packet of crisps.
Right, okay. I'm a horse now.
And thou must say nay and clippity-clop, added Sabrina.
Nay, nay, clippity-clop, clippity-clop, clippity-clop.
And thou must eat the packet of crisps in 10 seconds.
Right, anything, my love. Go.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I did it!
They have done well, fair knight. But the Lady of the Lake has decreed that I can only kiss a man after I have drawn over his face with ye old black marker.
Oh, I'm ready, my love.
You know I always like a man like this.
Oh, brilliant! Brilliant! Is that it? Is that it? Is that it?
Now we are ready, my love. At last we shall kiss.
Get in it!
Close thy eyes.
Right.
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Give it to us, kind. I mean, Sabrina.
Okay. Are you ready?
Aye. What a knockout kiss, man.
And so the powerful Sabrina and the unconscious Deck lived happily ever after until Sabrina had to go off and plug her new book on the Des O'Connor show. That is the end, especially for Ant. Thank you.
Hello and welcome back to SMTV Live, whatever that is.
Yeah.
Sir, permission to talk in a ridiculous accent?
Permission granted, Miss Deeley, as long as you get it right this time.
Okay. Bandits at 2 o'clock.
Brilliant. That means we've got loads of time.
Don't be such a damn fool, old man. Which means those flying bags of paint are back.
Darn it. Who can we get to man the gun?
What about? Scott from Five!
Yes, why not? Yeah. Let's get Scott. I'm kicking it. Scott, which got 300 before? Do you think you could beat that?
Well, Jimmy got 500, but I'm trying to beat that.
No, brilliant! Brilliant stuff on the line.
I think he's got fire in his belly.
Yes, we've got Gemma Noon from Manchester on the line. Good morning, Gemma.
I'm going to put these.
Hiya.
Hiya, she knew the answer to the question. What's the name of Shania Twain's latest single? Of course it was.
Man, I feel like
that's right, my dear. Okay, Zach, how do they play?
I tell you, you've got 45 seconds on the clock. You've got to get as many paint bags as you can. Each worth 100 points. Left, right, up, down, stop, and splat. Whoever's got the most out of you can win this ski holiday to the United States of America. Claire was on earlier. She got 300 points.
Yay!
300 to beat. That's what you have to beat to win the holiday.
That's the score to beat. Okay, good luck. Got your goggles on there. 45
I've got
seconds.
Them on.
Shocks away.
Left. Up, down, flat, left, flat.
Smart.
Down.
That's only 100 points there, which means Claire has won the holiday class. Claire, are you there?
Yeah.
You've just won a ski holiday in America for a week.
Any shorter than
that. How do you feel about that?
Excellent.
Are you very happy?
Yeah.
Good. Have a sniffing time, won't you? Congratulations.
Can I have your autograph?
Of course you can, my darling.
Well done, Claire. Well, bad luck. Scott didn't quite know there, did
you? Not talking about.
You're not talking about it.
Well done to Rich, who got you the points there before. But now, that gives me a tremendous sense of pride to throw over to the gorgeous Cat Deeley.
Now then, how do you fancy playing this morning, Wonkey Donkey, to make an important announcement?
Go on.
Sabrina.
Can't believe I ate the whole cake. Ooh, crumbs.
Don't you comedy could ever be this lame. Every week a different show, yet somehow all the same. We'll be chums forever. We'll be jolly with chums.
Previously on Chums, does Cat realize her long-lost twin sister Muggy's turned up after 42 years? Isn't it amazing what he can do with a little lip gloss? Find out this week in Chums. Chums is filmed before a live studio audience. Have a chance to escape.
I wonder who that is.
What does it say?
No! No! No!
And what's wrong?
No, that's what it says. No.
What about on the other side of it there?
Ah, yeah, you're right. No, it says, Dear Uncle Aunt, sorry about the other side. The letter, I was a bit panicky in case you'd forgotten your promise for my birthday. Oh, no!
Oh, Aunt, what have you promised?
Oh, well, you see, he's the biggest Emma Bunton fan in the world, you see.
Oh, Aunt, you haven't agreed that he'll meet Emma Bunton, have you?
No, it's worse than that, Kat. Far worse. Bar saw Latin door worse.
What?
Four Emma Buttons.
What did you go and promise him four Emma Buttons for?
Because he's greedy, that's why.
And where do you think you're going to get four Emma Buttons from?
Emma Buttons, all right?
Don't be so stupid, man. Shuts early on a Saturday, doesn't it?
Oh, it does, yeah.
Oh, what am I going to do, eh? What am I going to do?
Ant.
Uh-huh.
Control yourself.
Ant! Control yourself!
Ant! Control yourself.
Ant, son. Control yourself.
Control yourself! Ant! Stop it! I'll take his all on. You and our left.
Poo! Name the place.
Behind the sofa.
Right, sir.
Come on, then.
No!
Ow! Ow!
Stop it now. Are you all right?
I'm all right, Kat. But you want to see Ant? I've beaten him to a pulp.
Music. This is ridiculous.
What?
That's not a pulp. That's a Jarvis Cocker.
Kat, look, things are getting a little bit desperate. It's close enough, okay? Hang on.
Uh-huh.
I've just had an idea.
What?
Me and Sabrina and a jar of honey.
No. Look, I've got a more relevant idea.
Go on, then.
If I just convince the world and all of you that I'm Jarvis Cocker wearing this, who's to say I can't convince you all that I'm Emma Bunton?
We do!
Oh, shut up. Dick, lend us 20 pence, will you?
What for, like?
For the blonde wig and furry jacket vending machine that's just down the hall.
Oh, there you go.
Thanks very much. See you in a minute.
All right. Oh. Me and Kat, all alone in the flat together. I've got an inex to pick up. An inex?
a really strange urge that I think that I think I'm gonna kiss her.
Oh, Deck.
Oh, Cat.
Oh, Deck.
Oh, Cat.
Duh.
Oh, for goodness sakes, man.
It's Emma Bunton. Yeah.
It's Emma Bunton, everybody.
No, actually, everybody. It's me. Incredible, isn't it? It's your turn now. I've got your own jackets and your wigs there. Oh, no, that'll be my nephew. Quick, get ready. Ooh. But we haven't got another fourth.
I'm just going to have to go for it.
I just have to let him in, won't I?
Yes.
Yeah, will I? Look, it's some Blobbird, everybody.
And I've just moved in next door.
Oh, whatever.
No, look.
What?
She's blonde.
She's beautiful.
She's cute.
Which means
yes.
that she
could be the fourth Emma Bunton.
Yes, yes. Now, look at here, girl, right? Okay.
Right.
But, Ant's nephew's coming and we've got to give him four Emma Buttons. You just follow us, you're blonde, you'll do. Okay, it's the Spice Girls. I don't know if you've ever heard of them. Very good. And it's the girl called Emma, E-double-M-A, okay? But just follow us.
I am Emma.
Yes.
Yeah.
So am I, love.
And so am I.
And so am I.
Yes. Right, just follow us, right? One, two, three, four, loads of kicks and stuff like that. Woo. Hey, she's very great. She is very good.
Bad. Just follow me a little
she
bit
is
more.
She's very good. She about the wig, but apart from that, she's doing all
right. Yeah, she doesn't look nothing much like her, does she?
No.
Oh, that's my nephew. Okay. Get in line.
You've got to protect
Emma Bunton. I am.
Come on. Look, love, you're really getting on my nerves with Emma Bunton.
Can you wig on?
You finished? Can I open the door? Yes. Right. It's my nephew, everybody. Sit down, son. Look. Just what you wanted. Happy birthday for Emma Bunton.
Ta-da.
See, look here.
No, you don't understand. I didn't ask for four Emma Buntons. I asked for four button for my coat.
Oh!
Right, you little.
Will four adults poke the little boy in his little arm? Will they realize she's the real Emma Bunton? Can this script get any worse than this?
No!
Find out next week on Chums!
Wonkey Donkey, Wonkey Donkey,
Wonkey Donkey. Right. Earlier on, we asked you what is the name of Emma Bunton. So the band, of course, is the Spice Girls. Loads of people knew that. They've been telephoning us here at the show.
Don't you know how to play?
Yeah, right, okay.
Yeah, look, he's a wonky donkey. There's an animal, you've got to tell us what's wrong with it. And it must rhyme, ladies and gentlemen, please. I'm not going to say it again. It must rhyme.
It's got to rhyme. Okay, we've got five callers on the line who knew the answer to the question. At least you get 10 seconds. If you don't get up to 10 seconds, you know how to play. Okay, let's show this week's wonky donkey. Get it out of the curtains there. There you are. Take a good look at it there. Oh, we've got a caller at number one, Sally. Good morning, Sally.
Hello.
You got 10 seconds. What's that? Got a rhyme? Look at it there.
It's
a, look at his tail. He's
on a desert island.
Gonna happen for you there.
No.
1 second. On a bear, line two. Joanne, good morning, Joanne.
Good morning.
10 seconds. What's this?
Typhoon raccoon.
What?
Typhoon raccoon.
Nearly. It's a raccoon, but he's on a desert island. He can't get off it. He is.
Island raccoon.
No. Got a rain. Line three. Marilyn. Morning, Marilyn.
Morning.
10 seconds. What's this?
Raccoon Island.
No. No, man. For goodness sakes.
Save our souls, raccoon.
What?
Save our souls, raccoon.
What?
Save our souls, raccoon.
Line four.
It doesn't matter how loud you shouted, it's still not right.
Line four. Kelly, morning.
Morning.
10 seconds, what's that?
Raccoon. Island raccoon.
Yeah, he's on that. He can't get off the island.
Death is raccoon.
He's got a rain.
He's stuck on the island.
Maroon.
Raccoon. Raccoon.
Line four. five. Bank five is Sean. Sean, you've got 10 seconds. What have you got here?
Marooned Raccoon.
Yeah!
Well done, Sean, with no help from nobody. You got that yourself. Brilliant stuff.
You've won that virtual reality game. Congratulations, Sean, from everybody here at SMTV Live. Well done, mate.
Thanks.
Right now, though, let's have a little look at Kylie.
Little girl, know it's
oh, there you are.
Are you back?
As I was scratching my behind there. Thanks for surprising us.
But right now, though, let's have a chat to the lady herself. Please welcome Miss Kylie Minogue! Good morning, Kylie. How
Hello,
are you?
Hello, I'm very well. How are you?
Yeah, I'm very well indeed. You've been taking part all morning with us playing along.
Grandly. Well, I'm such a fan. So.
Oh, bless you.
So it's my absolute pleasure.
Bless you. Well, thanks for doing that. It's your first time down here on the show. You've been away for a while. What have you been up to?
I've been working on my book, mm-hmm. and I've just started working on a new album. So I've been quite busy.
Beavering away behind the scenes.
Yes.
Talking about your book, you just put the book together, shots of you over the years. What did the inspiration from that come from?
Because it's been about 12 years.
12 years?
Wow. Since I started, yeah. And it's just there's been so many pictures over the years, and I just haven't done one until now, and I just thought it was about time, really.
Mm. Yeah. And in the book, you've also got quotes from famous celebrities. Which one do you think is your favourite one?
I really like the one by Bono.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the little drawing one,
yeah,
isn't
it? Yeah,
it's
a teeny little...
So cute, so cute.
Even smaller than I really am.
And what, did you say something about being on stage?
It said, the stage is but a platform shoe. Believe me, I should know.
Yeah, very clever, very clever. But we also know that you have a bit of another fan, because I was in the States yesterday.
As you do.
Back yesterday, and I interviewed Robbie Williams, and he had a little something to say about you. So here it is.
Mm-hmm. And it's not coming out at Christmas.
Right.
It will come out when I get over the fact that, that I've got a crush. It's really eating at me. Every time I see Kylie, my stomach goes like a washing machine.
So hang on. Did you just phone her up to do a single because you fancied her?
That'd be really shallow of me.
But avoiding the truth.
You said it's a retrospective look over the past 12 years where it's been film, TV, music, stage. What's been your personal favourite time?
Oh, God. It's really hard to choose one moment because I've really done so much and worked with so many great people. Mm. I don't know. I couldn't even choose a favourite picture.
Really? Nah.
Actually, all right, the one that sprung to mind is there's a classic one of my sister and I. Whose name I won't mention.
No,
because,
not yet.
I can't give that away. But it was a classic late 80s moment.
All right.
Nice. On stage. Yeah.
We've got
so much.
We've got six of these to give away to our viewers. You can win that. You look at the pictures yourself. But you can only win them if you can answer this question. Kylie, what's the question?
It's very, very difficult. What is the name of my famous sister? Is it Danny? Annie? Or Granny.
So there you are.
If you think you know the answer, then write to us now at SMTV Live, PO Box 221-22, London SE1 9GL. Or you can fax us on 0207 737 8393. Or you can email us at studio@smtvlive.co.uk.
Kylie, thanks for coming down.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure to have you.
It has been brilliant.
But right now, with a world exclusive play of a brand new single, here's Jennifer Lopez with Waiting for Tonight.
I like her a lot. Anyway, now earlier on in the show, we were giving away goodies that Michael Owen had given us, including
this signed English shirt.
Now, we asked you a question, which was, which football club does Michael Owen play for? The answer was, of course, Kylie?
Liverpool!
Absolutely true. And the winner of all these goodies is?
Oh, Holly Robinson from Milton Keynes.
Excellent.
Stuff. Can I just say a big thanks to Kylie for coming on the show today?
Thank you.
Emma Bunton, you can see Emma and
F5
in CDK just after the break.
Yes, CDK coming up after the break. Before we go, though, we just have to... we're all very excited here in the studio this morning. We've got a new camera. We've had a camera delivered. It's the first one of its kind here in Britain. and we thought we'd give it a bash live on air. What it does, it actually allows you to see through people's eyes and into their heads, and it sees what they're thinking. We're all very excited. It's never been tried live on television. We may be a bit stupid, but you know, we're going to try it. Here it is. So if we can just cut it up here, here it is, camera six with Max.
Yeah. All right.
Let's give it a try here live on television. We're going to see what Cat Deeley is thinking about at this precise moment. Let's give it a bash, everybody. Let's hope it works. Fingers crossed.
Right, so it's CD UK next. I must remember my earpiece. Oh, and check that the battery in the radio mic's okay. Oh, and make sure that all the running order changes are up to date. So that's one, two, three things I've got to do. Right, I'll make sure I do those before.
It works! It does work!
Brilliant.
It works.
Fantastic.
Do you see?
Yeah.
Do you see what a professional
yeah.
I am?
That's good.
Can I have a look? I want to have a look in yours, okay. Please.
Here we go.
This is Declan's mine.
Oh, look at her. She's lovely, isn't she? Oh, yeah. Look at the way she walks. Oh, the only thing that would make this better if she had a cake. Oh, she's got a cake.
And finally, let's do Ant. Look at
it. Oh, look at it. Oh, that's brilliant. Brilliant. There you have it. I can't vouch for it. It's nothing to do with me. Do stay
tuned, though. At least it was better than before.
Don't talk about rehearsals, please. Do stay tuned, though, because after the break, we've got Emma Bunton, we've got Westlake,
we've got Hot Shots,
CDK News. It's CDK. It's after the break. Don't you dare go anywhere else. You're looking forward to it, aren't you?